It's the Dark Reading Fast Chat series. Welcome back to this series of interesting conversations on timely topics. Terry Sweeney here with Dark Reading, and joining me now is Mark Rasinovich as your CTO and technical fellow with Microsoft. Joining him is Daniel Rohr, VP Software Security with NVIDIA. Gentlemen, thanks for joining us for this Dark Reading Fast Chat.
Thanks for having us, Terry.
We are talking about NVIDIA GPU-enabled confidential computing on Microsoft Azure. Let's start with some context. Tell us a bit about how this collaboration began between Microsoft and NVIDIA on confidential computing, and a bit about what confidential computing even consists of. Mark, you want to kick us off?
Sure. So confidential computing is now the industry standard term for a type of hardware-based isolation. It consists of two key properties. One of them is that hardware creates an enclave or trusted execution environment in which code can run, protected from everything external to that enclave, including administrators on the server, the hypervisor, even physical access. And the second property of confidential computing is that the hardware can produce an attestation report signed by the hardware's key that describes what's inside the enclave, that the code in the enclave can produce and share with the external party. And that external party then can decide to trust the code in the enclave and the hardware protection, and then release secrets to it that allow it to perform computations on otherwise encrypted data inside that trusted execution environment. Now, confidential computing's been around for a while, and we've been driving this in Azure since around 2012. And we've worked with hardware partners, including AMD and Intel, to bring to market more sophisticated confidential computing hardware, including confidential virtual machine technology, which started to show up last year. Now, to have a comprehensive platform for confidential computing, you need, of course, accelerators to be confidential as well. And the key accelerator right now, given AI and data analytics use of GPUs, is a GPU. So a few years ago, we reached out to NVIDIA and suggested a partnership where we co-develop confidential GPU capabilities into their line of GPUs.
Excellent. Daniel, anything to add there?
Yeah, I mean, I think one thing that is sometimes lost is, you know, we've been partnering with Azure team for well on a decade. I think going back to K80 and forward, and we're constantly sort of looking and how do we look at our roadmaps? How do we find the best platforms for our common customers? And we actually started on confidential computing even before confidential computing with APM, which you all launched, I think, 2022 as sort of the first baby steps towards that sort of unified solution, but really trying to explore the space with partners and customers, figure out where the hard parts and software deployments to make that transition very simple and straightforward. And I think the H100 private preview ongoing now at Microsoft really demonstrates all the many years, I think, of hard work that we both invested to bring that platform to market.
And that was a great point, Daniel, that the fact is that we've had this partnership long before we started engaging on confidential computing, which made an engagement on confidential computing that much easier.
Yeah.
All right. Talk a little bit how this collaboration also enhances the security of AI workloads. How does that work exactly?
So I'll go ahead and take a stab, and then you can add on. I mean, I think when it comes to confidential computing and AI, it's I think the killer scenario for AI right now. There's a few different aspects where confidential computing can provide additional protections over and above what's currently available without it. One of them is protecting the models itself. The model weights more and more have expensive IP in them. And if you can keep them in an enclave, you can protect that IP. Another one is the data that's processed by those models. And there's two types of data. There's the data that's used to train a model or fine tune a model, which also can have very sensitive IP in. And then there's also the prompt and responses to the model at inference time, which also can be extremely sensitive. And so confidential computing with confidential GPUs can protect that type of data from end to end. And then the final scenario that it unlocks, which I'm really excited about, is multi-party confidential computing, where you've got different parties that want to collaborate with by sharing data to drive better insights out of that data, but they're not comfortable sharing or prevented through a regulation or other constraints from sharing that data with the other parties. With confidential computing, they don't have to share the data with each other. They share the data with the code and the enclaves.
I 100% agree. I think the gloss there is there are a lot of data stakeholders in this, from training data to use to inference to model, and IP rights abound. And being able to have full confidence in a platform where multiple collaborating parties with different interests can rendezvous and make the most of that data, I think is really a powerful paradigm going forward. And certainly Azure bringing a platform that's cloud enabled, likely where a lot of those entities already are and run major workloads, just makes that very simple to take it to that next level on these AI and AI informed workloads.
So let's imagine for a moment, and this is a big stretch of the imagination, but let's imagine that I am a SaaS provider. I am offering software as a service to customers, but I'm building it on an AI service with confidential GPU VMs on Azure. How is it that I would go about proving to my customers and to my customers' customers that I can't actually access their data? What's built into this this collaborative offering that you have that makes that easy to demonstrate? Can you walk us through that?
Yeah, I mean, Daniel, do you want to talk about the?
Yeah, I was gonna say, do you want me to take a swing at this one? I feel like you're carrying all the load right now. I think for CC, certainly trust in data at rest, data in motion, data in use, I think is sort of core of the CC concept today. But one thing that I think is often under or overlooked is sort of just the strength of attestation and claims and that hardware-backed assumption about what code is running on what system, and being able to bootstrap trust in an environment up from that in many different ways. And I think for a SaaS provider, being able to build trust both in the environment that he himself is, they or have deployed their environment, but also when they import customers' data, enabling patterns of like key escrow. And I think you at the top of the hour talked about, you know, unlocking data, unlocking secrets only after you've determined this environment is safe and comfortable for me to operate in. That works for the SaaS provider, but you could extend those capabilities out to the end user as well and really create sort of an end-to-end notion of trust. And even collaborating enclaves, the customer enclave with their data, with the SaaS enclave, and both getting mutually attested across to say, hey, do I trust this environment or this party that I'm going to interact with, and really build new collaborative models that would be very hard to do without those hardware-backed claims.
That's great. You also started onboarding preview customers earlier this year. Of course, we're curious about what you see in terms of usage patterns or specific use cases. What can you share about the trends that you've seen just in the limited time this has been available to a few preview customers?
Yeah, so I think that the kinds of industry verticals you would imagine would be interested in this are the exact ones that we see coming on board in the preview program. For example, healthcare, especially non-regulated healthcare where the development of new pharmaceuticals, where you're being able to protect the IP around the data that goes into the development of those pharmaceuticals, or protect the confidentiality of the different patients that are contributing to a study, for example, can be protected with confidential computing. So that's one where we see a lot of interest. Another one is in finance. We've got a customer, for example, that's implementing reinforcement learning in the procurement pay process with a strong emphasis on the privacy of the customer data that's going into that process. And so they want to protect that data from the surrounding environment, as well as even their own employees. And so they make that data available only to the confidential computing environment. And then finally, in insurance is another case where a lot of insurance is dealing with the legacy of processing documents that have been around with insurance claims, insurance policies. So there's lots of natural language processing that happens there. Again, domain-specific models being created to do analytics on top of that NLP database. And a lot of that is also very sensitive too. So another case where we see customers in the insurance space looking at it.
Right.
And I might add to that too. I think we're seeing, leaning into sort of those new collaborative patterns, sort of collective defense. You think about finance and fraud as sort of a collective concern around this $5 billion fraud market. You're seeing similar sort of patterns in cyberspaces as well, sort of new collaboration models to, again, erect collective defense, where pooling data from potentially otherwise competing entities to a common purpose is sort of building out in the market. So I think a lot of very interesting work going on. And again, an example of a large data problem that a lot of these other vertical markets are wrestling with.
Gentlemen, what can you tell us about the future of NVIDIA confidential computing on Azure? What sorts of features and capabilities can you share with us that may be in the wings?
Well, I can speak to NVIDIA. I don't speak for Azure, but I'm assuming they're going to deploy the next thing. So I think at GTC this year, we talked about Blackwell, and certainly we've been invested and continue to invest with Azure and in current and future platforms. We expect certainly the native performance scaling of GPUs as we move forward. We're looking at GPU to GPU encrypted bandwidth to, again, help that scale out and enable yet more sort of larger scale inference and compute dense workloads. We have the Nickel and the software layers to improve that, and certainly partnered with Azure to improve the attestation challenges and make that easy and make workload migrations into a CC environment as simple as running a non-CC today, regardless of running on 110 or 100 GPUs.
Yeah, and I think from an Azure perspective, of course, we're partnering deeply with NVIDIA and first to deploy their latest and greatest GPUs, which are getting, like Daniel's just suggested, stronger and stronger confidentiality capabilities in terms of scaling out from a single node. We're also fleshing out the software stack that goes around the hardware. And that's something we've been working on for a while. So you're going to see not just an IaaS box with a confidential GPU for you to use, but finished services on top that take advantage of that, including integrations into our AI platform over time, where we're making this available as kind of a serverless offering for doing things like confidential fine-tuning, confidential inference, confidential training. That's the evolution. And in general, what you're seeing is a move of Azure to become a confidential cloud, where confidentiality becomes pervasive, and that will be achieved when we've gotten rid of all of the kinds of limitations that are still there and blocking certain workload adoption of confidential community because of performance overhead or because of scaling limits in it that, like Daniel's addressing on the NVIDIA side. We've got Intel and AMD and ARM now addressing on the CPU side, and I expect that we'll be in that kind of phase in the next year to 2 years.
Excellent. So this is obviously a fairly leading edge kind of service. For customers who are trying to understand if this service is right for them, what sort of questions should they be asking themselves? Can you wrap us up with some thoughts there?
I mean, why aren't you already using it, I guess would be my first question. But, from the GPU side, I think certainly the focus around, your IO and compute ratios and making sure you sort of fit, form and fit. But I think pretty much any AI inference workload today is going to run great in an Azure environment. If you're running those sort of workloads, and I don't know a company that isn't doing that today, or at least claiming to do that today, those are great opportunities to really explore the space. It's only going to get better as it goes forward. Mark emphasizing how easy it is to migrate workloads today, and certainly NVIDIA invested a lot in the CUDA porting, where it's basically no code changes, and Azure in terms of the deployment side of that is making it equally easy. So start now. I think it would be my feedback.
Yeah, I totally agree with Daniel, and I think one of the cases that I would recommend customers look at adopting it is if you've got a data that right now that you view as too sensitive to move to the public cloud, this can remove that blocker. The fact that Absolutely. You can go and protect that with confidential computing.
Absolutely.
Mark, Daniel, some lots to chew on here, lots to think about. Thanks so much for joining us for this Dark Reading Fast Chat today.
Yeah, thanks for having me, Gary. Yeah.
Absolutely, thank you.
We've been talking with Mark Rusinovich of Microsoft Azure, along with Daniel Rohr with NVIDIA. This has been Terry Sweeney for the Dark Reading Fast Chat series. Thanks for joining us for this segment. We'll see you next time.